Hi everyone, this is Patty from A Soul's Heartbeat. I'm here today with another project for my creative spirit. And Claire had sent me the post-bound kit to do a mini with. So this is what the large post-bound album pack. It's 10 by 7. I'm going to leave links below the video for her store so you can find it. Mine came with the two main sheets, the two spine pieces, black tape, and the posts. And she has one on her website right now that's Alice, that you can buy all of this. It also gives you the Alice in Wonderland papers to cover it with. So check that out. I did three. I did this first one because I wanted you to see how you cover it with the black tape. Oh my God, I am in love with this black tape. I used it to repair a mini that the black paper that I had used to wrap with had split. And I about had a heart attack because I was scared I was ruining it. And oh my goodness, it made it so sturdy. You would never know that wasn't the way it was supposed to be. So I covered my edges in black tape, and someplace I misplaced the spine pieces. So I just threw a couple of chipboard pieces in so you could see what they were like. But this is what you get all pre-cut. So I'll leave the link. Go over and check out her website. Now, I have one that I've done. This is not Claire's way. This is Patty's way. I'm going to move this one out of the way because that's the correct one. And this one I did for a friend. So I can't show it finished because I don't know if the person that's going to receive this watches my videos or not. So I just have to have it plain and naked. But Claire's, and you'll see in the other one, Claire's fold inward like this, like the spine folds inward, these pieces. But I thought, why couldn't I leave them out, run some elastic cording through them, cut my inside papers, my black papers, larger so they fit the whole 7 inches. I put a pocket in the front. By the way, this is old paper I had, artisan style, and I folded the other one in here, Cityscapes Collection, just because this I kind of wanted the blueprint type of paper. So I have 10 sheets of black. I put a pocket on the inside. This is how I did the back. But I kind of thought that what this makes me think of is old, get over here and frame, old photographs that my grandma had from years and years ago. So this will be great because the recipient is going to be able to add more black sheets, whatever they want, and put more pictures in. And I am printing the pictures and putting in for this, but like I said, it's a gift and I don't want to spoil the surprise. Oh goodness, and I bet I can't. Maybe I can. I have, bear with me just a minute here. I have these, and I'm going to put this with this, and I'm going to put it up here in the corner with their name in it. I thought that would look really cool. So if they all say it's okay, maybe I'll film it with pictures in it and show you that afterwards so you can get an idea. But that's the second one I made, and a different idea of how to do it. I did put the eyelets in, and I did put black hole reinforcers all over in here, so it would just make it sturdier. Now, this is the one that Claire sent me, the everything, including the tape and the post thingamagiggers, and this paper collection by Graphic 45. Well, I gotta tell you, this wasn't my favorite paper collection. I had a real hard time with it. That's why you see purple on the front instead of anything else, and purple on the back. But then I thought, oh, just get in with it. And you know, it's like a lot of things. It kind of takes on a life of its own. So as I started playing with it, it just all came together. But you can see, this, my friends, is all I have left over. And I see, stuck down in here, I have one of the journaling cards. Because Claire had given me the 8x8 pad and the pad of journaling cards. I used it all, every bit. So I did this one up a little different too, so I'll show you. I added a chipboard piece that I had in my stash, and I painted it with Timmy paints in the Wicked Orchid or Wild Orchid or whatever it is in black. And this is from the paper collection, as is this. And you can see I have glossy accents and stickled this. I did not do step-by-step because if you buy Claire's kit, I don't know if you can just buy the PDF or not, but the directions are all there, plus directions to our video, so you can go check those out. So, let me see. Oh, looky there. I can get it all in frame. Wonderful. I made a pocket on the inside. This is one of the journaling cards. Now, let me tell you what I did different here. I took Claire's black tape, and because I was afraid of how much wear and tear this would get, and I thought, I'm just going to try it and see what happens. Let me get it. Okay, here you can see. I took the black tape on each one of my black card, and I reinforced the hinge part, putting it over the hinge. So a little bit goes to the right, a little bit goes to the left, where the fold will be, where it's going to fold, each page is going to fold, just to give it more reinforcements, because I'm only using just a single sheet of black card for each of my papers. So that might be something that you want to think about. Also, as I go through, if there's something that I've done specifically that you don't know how to do and would like to, send me off a comment, excuse me, send me off a comment or an email and say, hey Patty, I don't know how to do that, show me in a video, and I'll do a short video on how to do that particular process. So in the pocket I have this little booklet here, and these are two of the journaling cards, and I have hinged them together again with Claire's handy dandy black tape. Love that stuff, I love it. And it goes in here, and yes, this paper is in that paper collection. It was one of the B-sides, as was the liner paper here. On this side, I have a pocket, and this is one of the pockets that you can have a hidden something or other. You can put a tiny picture, you can put a note card, you put some ticket stubs, whatever you want. It just folds up. And then I have two journaling cards. I have not done anything to them except ink around the outside edge, and they fit right in here. I did do a lot of fussy cutting, but you know me, that's enjoyable to me. So I have a lot of these little vehicles, whether they be a steam engine or an airplane or a car, that I have put here and there throughout the book. When we turn the page, I have mirrored pockets. In other words, they both angle up this way. And I'm going to get a piece of, I'm going to get a piece of black card and just stick it behind there so it doesn't take away from the page I'm showing you. Okay, the pocket this side has another, this is a trifold. So this is a 12 by 6 piece of paper that I've just scored, and I put another one of the fussy cut piece and a piece from the paper on here. Now, when you do this, it's always nice to give yourself a little bit of leeway so it doesn't butt right up, so you have, it's not fighting itself when you fold it. And then this goes in here. I have a pullout that goes in the pocket here. On this side, the pullout is on the top part, like this. I love it. And I have double backed them in the black and the purple. I love being able to add the purple in this. And I have another bifold on this side, like this. And then on the back of this one, I have a car that says Adventure Awaits. And it goes in the pocket here. But you can see the pockets are full, or not full, they're big, so you can put lots of stuff in them. Now when we turn this over to the next page, I have a torn piece here that I've backed with the cream. I have a piece that I've cut out from the paper here with a, this was actually a bicycle, but it was on the edge of the paper, so I made it into a unicycle. And I added more of this ribbon that's from my stash. Here's one of the tags in here. Here's a huge mat here. And on this one, I cut it apart like this. So you have a template to cut your photo that will go right here, and it will fit. There we go. It'll fit right in this circle. So that's the template that whoever gets this can use to cut your picture out. And it flags in the photo here. This would make a great, great travel album, you know, or if somebody's going, when we get to go on trips again, I know because of COVID, we're all kind of housebound, but someday that will be over and you'll all get to go on trips again. I use the journaling card, the postcard here, as a pocket, and I have a lovely mat that matches that one just with a black here. And then on this, I did a belly band, just slides off like that. And then I think this is a, nope, this is four. And the way I got it to be four is I took the piece and divided it half, and the piece and divided it half, and I seamed them together with, you got it, more of this lovely, lovely tape here. And then I just inked around everything. I have another one of my little fussy cut pieces here and here, and it folds, let's see, folds like, don't remember, folds like that. Okay, so you open it up, folds in, folds in, folds that way. And I use my corner chomper. This is the cloud corner chomper here that I use. And then I just have this, I have this little belly band here that it just slides. Well, it isn't difficult to do. There we go. It just slides over the top. Now, I think it goes like this, like that. And then it slides in the pocket. All right, the next page. I have another pullout here with a huge mat, purple, that goes in this frame. So you can put your picture on. I'm not gonna do it. It's too hard for me to do it on camera because I get stressed. But what I wanted to tell you, when you put this in, oh, there, now, see, of course, this time it's gonna go in with no problem. And I need a skinny little, this is the one that Claire sent me, the bone folder. There we go. If you're going to put a picture, you want to put a picture in here, what I would suggest is very lightly take your pencil and make a pencil mark on the purple of where your picture will sit. Go just a little bit beyond that edge. See, you can't go too far here. It's going to show on the outside. A little bit beyond that edge, then you have perfect placement for when you slide your photo back in your frame. Here, I've taken just a scrap of that paper from the front and backed it with the cream to make a really nice pocket here. These are the tags, just with more black on the back. I have 9 pages, I think, in this instead of 10. I'm not sure. I can't remember. Here we have a stopper here and a stopper there. This purple comes out. That's your template to put your photo in. When you put your photo, and well, I would put my photo so that it left a little bit of purple border on it. And the same way with the back. You can have a photo on the front and the back. And then it just slides underneath. Get lost. The possibilities are endless. I just made a little cluster there. That way it holds your photo in. You can put one on the front and the back of the purple. Plus, you can also put one underneath on the cream-colored mat. So you can put 3 photos here and then a little journaling about them. On this side, this is just a mat with lines here that I drew with my white Signo pen. I'm having a really hard time with white pens. So if any of you have a suggestion about what you use that you love that's a white pen, would you drop me a comment down below? My problem is I don't use them often enough, and then when I go to use them, they don't want to come out. And yeah, I use the trick where you rub them on your fingers and everything. I finally got it to work, but it's a pain. This is one of my hidden paper clips. There's a large paper clip hidden inside of here. If you go to my videos under my playlist, I have a section called How Do You Do That? And it's the hidden paper clips. I'll try to remember to put the link to that video in the description box so you can see how to make these. And see, here it is here too. And it just slides off and your paper clip is hidden down in there. Then we have this little book here that gives you 1, 2, 3 great big spots for huge photos. And that just stays by taking our paper clip and sliding it over. I'm going to have a terrible time. I got to shake something terrible today. I guess I've had too much coffee. Okay, there we go. And it just slides over the top like that. on both sides. You can adjust it wherever you want. I think I had it right there. There we go. On this side, oh, I had fun doing this one. On this side, I wanted graduated, well, I started with a big mat at the back to go under my belly band, but it just slid. And I really hate taping the belly band down any closer to the mat because then it's a struggle getting it in. So I thought, well, why don't I do graduated mats? So I have one, two, three, and four. Now, you can do four photos on the backs of these, or you can do eight photos and just use a border part of whatever your print is and put your photo in the middle of it. But I still have kind of a problem with it wanting to slide. So I took one of these huge paper clips and my flag punch here, and I just took and I cut the scraps apart and I made the flags for the front and back, and I just hooked them right over the pieces of my paper clip. So they're glued over that permanently. And then when I slide these in like this under the belly band, and you have the little part here that you can put notes on, and let's put it over on this side so you can see. I also had a spot here and a huge, huge mat on this one. Now I wanted to show you these. What these are, and I don't know which one it came out of, but they're the little piece that comes out of the bottom of your tag punch. And of course, no, I don't throw those away either. And this just slides underneath here like that, under my giant belly band. And we go over here and we can put these back however we want them again, like this. Then you take your paper clip. I just messed up this side. You take your paper clip and you just slide it on like that and underneath. And it holds everything, and you've got these nifty little cute little flag things that are there as well. I don't think I have that one underneath. There we go. And I want to slide this one just a little bit. And there you are. And that holds it all in place. I just thought that was kind of fun. I got this giant paper clips at Tuesday morning, and I already showed you this one. And see, then on this side you also have a flag that comes down over the pendant, so that works great too. On this one, I love this paper, so I just cut a split. I took my crocodile like this, and I put two holes in, and I put eyelets on them. And then I took, you got it, I took some of my black tape, and I just bound the top of these so that, mainly not for stability, which it will be good for that as well, but I wanted them to pop more, so I put the tape between. I ran ribbon through these and tied them and everything, and I just didn't like the look. I like the looks of the eyelets, but I didn't like the idea of putting more fluff in there, so I left them the way they are. Behind this this mat, because this is just a 8x8 page cut down and then sliced in a couple slices, I put black backing on it, and so I could have a great big pocket here that comes almost to the bottom for these two mats. They're all backed in the lovely purple. And I think that is a Basil smoothie cardstock, this purple stuff that I'm using here. And then on the little one, it holds this one and it holds this one like that. This is a really fun idea. I don't think I have a video showing how to do that, but if you have any problems, let me know. Over here we have another pocket with these again are from the leftovers, and these I just did the front pretty parts, and then I backed them in black like this. And then there's a great big mat that goes in this pocket. I did use one of my circle punches. Why is it always that way when you're on camera? Nothing wants to slide in the way it's supposed to. I don't know what I'm hitting here. Okay, get in there. There we go. There we are. See, you just got to talk to it. Be forceful. Okay, these I just wanted it so it kind of gave a little bit more definition. I guess that one's up first, and then this one. A little bit more definition when it was in the pocket. And I used one of my, I think it's a 2.5 punch or a 2 1/4 inch circle punch just to make my opening there. This side has just my journal card here backed in black. It has a cut apart here and one here. I love this one. But those are your stoppers. Now, you've got room here. You can put a big picture. Then you can put a picture on here. And again, you can put a picture on here. So you could have three on this page. And the ones that are on the black would be glued right to the black. This one I left so you could take it in and out. I just love how that fussy cut out. Again, this is the other part of that one circle, and I have another one here that shows you a template to cut your photo this size. You can cut it as big as the outer ring, front and back if you want, and then it just slides right in here, and the colored part is what fits in. I guess we should do it so it's more there, straight up and down. I still don't have it quite right, but close enough. This one, I don't know if you can see it or not, but after I fussy cut it out, I put some clear acetate in the windows. I thought that was cute. A little plane up here. Here we have, now this one I did use a magnet because my brain wasn't working. I couldn't figure out how to get it closed without having a magnet. So I do have one magnet from my stash in here. This pulls down. Well, let's take these out first. I have two mats in this pocket. The pocket is between the journaling card and the black mat. So I have these two in there. And then you pull it down like this. Let me get this up here. You pull it down like this, and you have between the backing of this and the back of this, I have another pocket. Well, I was really running out of paper by this time, so this is a pieced piece on a purple background that sits right in there. Now, when you come here, I have some more fussy cut pieces, and you flip it up. See if I can get it in here. You've got this nice piece. You can leave it as an ornament with just these beautiful pictures on it, or you can put a gigantic photo on it. I've got the hiccups, you guys, so excuse me if you hear me hiccuping. I'm trying not to, but the more you convince yourself not to, it seems like the more you can't stop yourself. Okay, then I have this, just this cream colored matte, and I know it has inkies all over it, but that doesn't matter because the photos are going to go in here and cover all of that up anyway. So then this comes down, this goes up, these go in here, but just like an infomercial, but wait, there's more. In here, I left it free between here and the back sheet. So again, I have a gigantic photo mat that slides in there. And again, I didn't have any paper left, so I just cut and tore it and put it all on the front and the back and made like a kaleidoscope one. I love it. Cute. I didn't throw any papers away that way. I used everything. Again, I used the cloud corner chomper and the half-inch corner chomper on this. Makes it nice and sturdy, so it should just slide right in there. Sometimes what I want it to do and what they actually do on camera are two different things. So get back over here. So that's that one. And on the last page here, I have this corner piece, and I wanted it to kind of tie in with these. So this is part of this paper, this corner pocket. And you can see I took the flowers here, and they are this strip of flowers, and I fussy cut them all out, and then I just kept pasting them onto there. And another piece of my ribbon that's just stapled on. I have a little booklet here like this, again with the Claire's tape that I joined it with in the middle. Makes it really sturdy when you use that tape. And then this is just one of the smaller journaling cards, and I just glued it on the back of the black because I thought it looked really nice that way. And this slides right in there like that. And then on the back, I just have a pocket with a smaller little booklet. And you know, I should have counted to see how many photos you can get in there. I know when Claire showed hers, she hadn't put anything on the inside, but I couldn't resist. I just had to play with it. And then I also left this free here. So, oh, I know. Look at what we have. That must be why I had it. We have this I found. I wasn't too thrilled with this. Pass, all the paths you take in life, make sure a few of them are dirt. It's John Muir from the, It Wasn't He Yosemite and like that, which is okay, but we'll put this one in instead. Enjoy your journey. So yay, I just have to ink around it and it's all done. And then there's just the back cover like that. Let me pull out my black card. This is some black card that Claire had sent me. And then we go here again, and that's it. So this is my five, I'm sure it's, let me make sure here. It is 7 by 10. And then this is the other one. Now see, this one is bigger because we left, you can really see. These are the ones where you leave the flaps out and I put the elastic cording in, and then you can put as many pages as you want inside. It will grow with you. This one is done the way it's supposed to be, with these flaps folded back on themselves, with the post, I don't know where I set those, but with the metal posts inside. Now if I had too many pictures, say I wanted to do double what I have here and put 9 more pages in, all you have to do is get post extenders to extend those, and you can make it 20 inches high if you want to. The sky's the limit. So there we go. There are my two books from Claire. I will send you over to my Creative Spirit store. So, and this was, let me tell you right now, this was kit number C like Charles, B like Boy, 0027. And I will put that information in the About section right below the video. So thank you everyone for joining me. I had great fun making this. I hope Claire likes how I tweaked her little design here. Have a great crafty day, everyone. Bye-bye now.